Hello everyone, this is Mike and you are watching Really. So John Lennon made a few enemies in his lifetime, which isn't all that surprising when you consider his enormous influence on popular culture. With the Beatles, he was one half of perhaps the greatest songwriting partnership of the 20th century. As a solo artist and activist, he served as an ambassador for peace in an era of turmoil and conflict. As an individual, he was never far from controversy. Well, as you'll discover, Lennon didn't hate these artists in an absolute sense. He simply took a disliking to what they appeared to represent and even what was subject to change. With that said, let's begin, and please do not forget to subscribe to our channel. Moving on, Paul McCartney. Well, John Lennon's complicated relationship with Paul is well documented, from the early days in Liverpool to the Beatles split in 1970. Next up we have Blood, Sweat and Tears. Despite spending years at close quarters with the UK and US chart systems, John Lennon rarely listened to the top 10. Only when I'm recording or about to bring something out will I listen to the top 10, he told Rolling Stone in 1971. Then we have Juan Baez. Okay, in that same 1971 interview with Rainer, Lennon named two folk musicians he simply refused to listen to. His comments came after Rainer made the mistake of comparing Lennon's working class hero to the work of Bob, a comparison that always drew a bad response. Then we have Frank Zappa. Okay, on one level, John Lennon related to Frank in Lennon Remembers. He expresses his hatred of critics while shunning those who fail to respect his genius. To illustrate this far from modest point, he compares himself to Frank, who next up, Bob. This one might come as something of a surprise. Bob was an important influence on Lennon, who started adopting elements of the single, songwriter's introspective songcraft in the early 1960s, giving birth to watershed albums like Robot Soul.